Language Rich Europe is a project funded by the European Commission, which is being led by the British Council, and it's actually a consortium of 30 partners, including all the EU national institutions of culture. They've just published a baseline report which looks at language provision and language learning in 25 countries across Europe. The Language Rich Europe report has a chapter on Scotland. The good news in the chapter is that Scotland was one of the very first adopters of primary foreign language learning back in 1992, and the Scottish Government is committed to having a 2+1 language provision at school, so that in addition to the mother tongue, all students should learn two foreign languages. Some of the more worrying trends in the report are that if you take pupils at secondary level, in 2001 nearly all pupils were taking foreign languages up to fourth year, whereas in 2011 this had dropped to 67%. So we've seen quite a large drop in the numbers of students carrying on with languages through secondary school. Because of pressures on public funding, we've seen quite a dramatic decrease in the number of foreign language assistants coming to Scotland, so that in 2005 we had 285 foreign language assistants, but by 2011 this had dropped to 59. Actually, there's been an increase in the last year, and so promisingly we've seen those numbers go back up to 70. Because of squeezes on budget, further education colleges and universities are seeing quite a dramatic reduction in the numbers of courses that they can offer, and the number of students who want to take those courses. And in fact, at further education colleges, there's a worry that this foreign language teaching will collapse completely. There's been a belief amongst employers that English is enough, and this clearly isn't the case, because what we're seeing is that Scottish companies are exporting predominantly to Anglophone countries, because that's where they can find English speakers, and they're avoiding other countries because they can't find trusted partners in those other countries. So there is a linguistic element to the barriers that exist to export. It's limiting Scotland in a number of ways, socially, intellectually, culturally, and economically, because we're not able to export worldwide. Earlier data that was collected by the British Council showed that business leaders were looking for young people with the skill set to go out on the world stage and just couldn't find them, because students were leaving college, leaving schools, without the language abilities and without a good understanding of other cultures and other nations. And the Scottish Government wants to see Scotland adopt its rightful place on the world stage. But in order to be able to do that, we've got to have young people who are prepared to go out into the world and sell Scotland to the rest of the world. And they need to understand other cultures, they need to speak other languages if they're going to do that successfully.